Hello learners, this is Dr. Vishal Sood, teacher educator. In the previous lesson, we have discussed about measurement and assessment processes. As you know, the measurement and the process of assessment, they are very essential to know the efficacy or the effectiveness of the teaching learning process. The assessment process tells us about whether the instructional objectives or the objectives of teaching as framed by the teacher have been achieved or not. Moreover, assessment also tells us about the effectiveness of the teaching learning strategies adopted by the teacher and the teaching learning material adopted by the teacher during the classroom transaction process. So, these two processes about which we have already learned in the previous lesson, they are most important for the successfulness of this teaching learning process. In today's lesson, we are going to discuss about another process, that is evaluation, which is synonymously used with assessment. And today's our topic of discussion will be measurement, assessment, and evaluation, certain basics. So, the discussion of today's part will focus on, that is a brief overview of measurement and assessment. That means we will discuss about the previous processes that we have discussed in the previous lesson, that is measurement and assessment. Then we will discuss about the meaning and elements of the evaluation process. Then afterwards we will discuss, we will deliberate on similarities and differences between the assessment and evaluation processes. And in the last part of this today's lecture, we will discuss about the need and importance for evaluation. So today's our discussion will focus on these four points. So, let us start with the brief overview of measurement and assessment about which we have already discussed in the previous lesson. Now, what we mean by measurement? As you know, measurement refers to the process by which the attributes or dimensions of some object or phenomena are quantified. As you already know, that means when any attribute, any quality or any characteristic of any object is quantified or is expressed in terms of quantity along with a unit, then that process is referred to as measurement. In teaching learning process, measurement of academic achievement can be done with the help of tests, and that test is known as an instrument of measurement. Whereas, on the other hand, we have already studied about the process of assessment. Assessment is a process by which information is obtained relative to some known objective or goal. That means, in assessment, there is an objective, and around that objective, this assessment process is carried out. Assessment of learning or assessment of academic achievement or performance refers to the collection of all possible data and evidences with respect to learning of concepts in a particular subject. That means, in assessment, only the quantified data are not obtained, rather in addition to quantified data or in addition to the quantitative data, qualitative data are also obtained in the process of assessment, and this collection of quantitative and qualitative data is done with the help of different tools or devices which are known as assessment tools. So, that means measurement is a process which is narrower in scope, whereas assessment is more wider in scope as compared to assessment. Measurement is the quantification of the attributes or the quality or the characteristic of any object, whereas assessment includes both the quantification as well as gathering of the qualitative information about the object or the human being. As in case of teaching learning process, we can assess the achievement or the learning performance of the students. So, there it is not only to gather the marks or to collect the marks with the help of test. We also try to assess what are the particular learning styles of the student, what difficulties are being faced by the students during the process of learning. So, all these are included in the process of assessment, and measurement is a part of that assessment. So, about all this, the measurement and assessment, we have already studied in the previous lesson. Now, today's our main discussion will focus on another process which is known as evaluation. Evaluation is a term which is interchangeably or synonymously used with the process of assessment. Now, what we mean by evaluation? Evaluation refers to the value judgment made about the phenomenon, taking into consideration the quantitative or the qualitative information collected on it over a particular period of time. Now, what we refer to this? Evaluation means we try to make value judgment about the process, about the teaching learning process. For example, teaching learning process is a phenomenon. Teaching learning process is a procedure, and about that teaching learning process, in evaluation we try to make value judgment, taking into consideration the quantitative or the qualitative information or academic achievement of the student. It is also a phenomenon. About the academic achievement of the student, we try to make the value judgment with the help of evaluation. And for this academic achievement of the student, we gather the quantitative information through different measurement tools or through different measurement devices. And we also gather qualitative information about the student's performance or academic achievement over a long period of time. So that means evaluation is what? Evaluation includes quantitative information about the phenomenon plus qualitative information about the phenomenon plus a value judgment is made about that phenomenon. That means evaluation includes three things. One is the quantitative information. The second is the qualitative information about the phenomenon under consideration. And the third is the value judgment about that phenomenon. So, all these three things make evaluation. In other words, we can say that quantitative information is the measurement of the attributes, whereas the qualitative information is a part of assessment. And value judgment is another feature which is added in the process of evaluation. That means evaluation includes measurement, assessment plus value judgment. So, this is evaluation. On the basis of evaluation, all possible information regarding the learning of the child, both quantitative and qualitative, are to be properly collected and carefully analyzed before making any judgment on his her learning status or the progress. What this means? This means when we try to collect information or when we try to make value judgment about a child, whether he has succeeded in this particular learning task or not, if we want to make certain value judgment regarding that, or if we want to make certain value judgment regarding the teaching learning process carried out by the teacher in the classroom, then all possible information regarding the academic achievement or regarding the learning of the child, we try to collect both the quantitative information as well as the qualitative information. Now, how we collect quantitative information? That is with the help of testing devices. That is with the help of tests or examinations. Now, when the test is taken, a score or marks are awarded to the students on that particular test. So, that is measurement. That means quantitative information is gathered about the student's achievement. And other is qualitative information. Now, qualitative information, what is the pace of learning of that particular student? What learning styles have been adopted by that particular student? So, all this information, what learning difficulties have been faced by the student during learning of that particular concepts. So, all these type of qualitative information are properly gathered, they are analyzed, and after analyzing, an interpretation is made or judgment is made regarding the learning progress or the learning status of the child. And this whole process is known as evaluation. That means first we gather the quantitative information along with the qualitative information about the learning of the child. And on the basis of that information, we try to analyze that. We try to examine that quantitative information and the qualitative information, and the on the basis of that we try to make any judgment. We give a judgment about the learning progress or the learning status of that child, and this whole process of examining the quantitative information, qualitative information, and making the value judgment is known as evaluation. Now, what we received from this all, we received that evaluation is a process which includes measurement, that is the quantitative information, plus assessment, that is the qualitative information, plus a value judgment about the learning status, about the learning progress of the child is made, and this is process which is called as the process of evaluation, which is having the widest scope as compared to measurement and assessment. Now, what elements constitute evaluation? As we have already discussed, that evaluation includes the quantitative information as well as the qualitative information. That means both measurement and the assessment are the parts of evaluation. Evaluation is having the widest scope, whereas measurement is a part of that. We gather quantitative information about the learning progress of the child. We gather qualitative information about the child's learning, and that is also a part of evaluation. Plus, on the basis of analyzing the measurement results and assessment results, we give a value judgment about, or we make a value judgment about the child's learning process, and this whole process is known as the process of evaluation. So, the two elements of evaluation are measurement and assessment, plus on the basis of that value judgment is made. This is also a part of the process of evaluation. Now, what are the similarities and the differences between assessment and evaluation? We will discuss on these issues. What similarities are there? Because these two terms, assessment and evaluation, they are synonymously used by the teachers or the academicians or the parents. So, what are the similarities? Assessment refers to the collection of data and the gathering of evidence from different sources through different tools. As we have already discussed in the previous lesson, that assessment means collection of the data or gathering of different evidences through different tools, through different devices, and these data may be related to the student's learning, his learning styles, the learning difficulties faced by that particular child, or his pace of learning. So, all these type of data are collected in the process of assessment, whereas evaluation refers to bringing meaning to the collected data through interpretation, analysis, and reflection. That means, in evaluation, what we do, we take the data from the assessment process and the measurement process, and we try to interpret that data. We try to give a meaning to that data collected on the basis of the process of measurement and evaluation. We try to analyze that data, examine that data, try to give a meaning to that data or interpret that data, and we try to reflect on that data, and finally we make a value judgment regarding the learning status or the learning progress of that particular child. So, that means this is the difference. In assessment, we collect data, we gather the evidences about the student's learning progress, and in evaluation, we go one step ahead of that. We give a meaning to that data, we reflect on that data, and finally we make a value judgment about the learning status or the learning progress of that particular student. So, this is the first difference. Second difference you can see on the screen, that assessment provides feedback on performance of the student, specifying his or her strengths and areas for improvement, which provides insights for taking appropriate steps for improving the learning. That means, on the basis of assessment results, we provide feedback to the students regarding his performance or regarding his strengths in a particular learning task, or what are his weaknesses where he or she requires improvement. So, in assessment, the strengths and the weaknesses of a student in a particular learning task, they are identified, they are specified, and the insights or the suggestions for taking appropriate steps are given so that learning could be enhanced among the students. That means assessment is a process in which feedback regarding the strengths, regarding the weaknesses, regarding the particular learning difficulties are identified and steps are taken for appropriate improvement of learning among the students. So this is assessment. In case of evaluation, we try to examine the evidences collected through measurement and assessment processes, and we try to determine the standard met and the levels of success or failure in meeting these standards. That means in evaluation, what we do, we try to make a judgment whether the student has achieved the objectives of teaching learning process or not, whether the standards have been met by the student or not, or whether the student has succeeded or failed in meeting the set parameters or not. That means the evaluation gives us the final result, gives us the final result or final achievement of the parameters or the standards of standards set by the teacher for the students. So that means assessment is to find out the strengths, to find out the weaknesses, and to give suggestions for improving the learning. Whereas evaluation goes one step ahead, on the basis of which we try to determine whether the set parameters, whether the set standards have been met, or to what extent the student has succeeded or failed in meeting those parameters or not. That means evaluation is the final result or the value judgment about that particular process. Now, in both the processes, the similarity is there. In both the processes, that is assessment and evaluation, the instructional decisions are carefully made by examining evidence of students' performance, attitude toward learning, and understanding over a period of time. That means in both the assessment processes as well as the evaluation processes, the instructional decisions, the decisions regarding the teaching learning process are carefully made by examining, by taking into consideration the students' performance. That means how to teach the students in future course. Those decisions are based on students' performance. What is the attitude of the students towards learning? On the basis of this, instructional decisions or decisions regarding the curriculum transaction or decisions regarding the classroom processes are taken by the teacher. And what is the attitude of the student towards the content matter or the teaching learning process? They all are taken into consideration, and on the basis of that, the instructional decisions or the instructional strategies or the lessons are designed by the teacher. That means assessment and evaluation, they are similar to a larger extent, and that is why very often both the terms are used synonymously. We sometimes use assessment, we sometimes use this evaluation word, but these are used interchangeably. But the difference is that assessment is narrower in scope, whereas evaluation is more wider in scope. If we compare the three processes, measurement, assessment, and evaluation, measurement is the having the lowest or narrowest scope. Assessment is having comparatively more scope as compared to measurement. Whereas evaluation, which includes both measurement and assessment, so having the widest scope. Measurement is only the quantification of the attributes of the attributes or the characteristics or the qualities of any object or a human being. Just like the academic achievement is a characteristic of the student, and when that academic achievement of a student is measured with the help of a test, then that process is known as the process of measurement. Assessment, we try to gather qualitative information along with quantitative information. Just like What are the particular learning styles? What learning styles have been adopted by the student? What are the particular learning difficulties have been faced by the student? What was the pace of learning of a particular student? So about all these aspects, the information is gathered through different sources, through interaction with the teachers, through interaction with the peer group, through observation in the classroom processes, to what extent the student has participated in the teaching learning process. About all these aspects, different sources are taken into consideration. On the basis of that, the information is gathered, qualitative information is gathered, and this makes a part of the assessment process. That means assessment includes both the quantitative information gathered through the tests and qualitative information gathered through interactions or gathered through observations. So that quantitative plus qualitative information makes the process assessment. Whereas in evaluation, we go one step ahead of this gathering of quantitative as well as qualitative information. We try to examine that. We try to analyze that quantitative and qualitative information and try to give a meaning to that, or try to reflect on that quantitative and qualitative information and make a value judgment. Make a value judgment regarding the process, or we try to give a decision regarding whether the set standards or set parameters have been met out or not, or to what extent the student has succeeded or failed in a particular learning task. So we try to make a value judgment, we try to make a decision about that. That whole process, that process is known as the process of evaluation. So evaluation includes measurement, assessment plus value judgment. So now evaluation, why evaluation, what is its need? There are certain queries. Is there any need of conducting evaluation? What processes constitute evaluation, which we have already discussed that evaluation includes measurement, assessment plus value judgment. Then when to evaluate, whether it should be a single shot event or it should be a continual, it should be a regular, it should be a periodic process. Then what to evaluate? All dimensions of holistic personality of the child, or some particular dimensions of, or only the intellectual domain of the personality of the child? Then how to evaluate? Whether there is any single tool or single technique to evaluate the student's progress, or there are multi tools and multi techniques to evaluate the student's progress in different dimensions. So these are the queries which we as a teacher must ask to ourselves, that what is the need of evaluation, how evaluation can be carried out, when to evaluate, what part of child personality are to be evaluated, should it be a continual process, should it be a regular process. So these queries, first, why the need of evaluation is there? You can see on the screen that the evaluation is needed to ascertain child development in various dimensions at different stages. That means at different stages, at the childhood stage, at the adolescent stage, at the adulthood stage, how a individual has developed in terms of different dimensions. That for that purpose we need evaluation. Then another need to evaluate the student's progress is to certify the learner in terms of what has been achieved and what is still missing. That means as a teacher, you also make assessments, you also take tests in the schools, and you try to find out whether the student has achieved or whether the student has learned this particular concept or not, or what are the particular learning difficulties which are faced by the students. You do this thing in class. And why you do that? You do that to certify the learner whether what has been learned by the student and what is not understood or what is still missing in that particular aspect. In order to do that, we need evaluation. Then, to identify the learning difficulties of the child. What are the learning difficulties? What are the particular parts of the content matter which have not been understood by the child? In order to identify those learning difficulties, in order to identify those hard spots, we need evaluation. Then, on the basis of that identification of those hard spots or the learning difficulties, what we do? We provide remedial instruction. We provide remedial measures so that those learning difficulties could be removed and learning could be enhanced among the students. So for this purpose, how on the basis of evaluation results, we try to make or we try to design remedial measures so that learning can be enhanced among the students. Then to ascertain effectiveness of 3 M's, we require evaluation. Now these 3 M's are matter, methods and materials. First we try to identify or we try to ascertain whether the content matter which was taken for the teaching learning process, to what extent that content matter was effective. Whether the student have taken interest in learning that content matter. In order to ascertain the effectiveness of content matter, we need evaluation. Secondly, in order to transact that particular content matter or in order to make the students learn about that particular content matter, we apply different teaching methods, we apply different teaching strategies in order to ascertain, in order to know to what extent those teaching methods, those teaching strategies have been effective. In order to do that, we need evaluation. If the students have understood about the content matter through a particular teaching method or through a particular teaching strategy, then we can say that that particular method or strategy has been successful in terms of teaching learning of this particular content matter. So for that we need evaluation. We try to evaluate the student, and on the basis of that evaluation we try to evaluate or we try to make a value judgment about our own teaching methods, our own teaching strategies. So evaluation is needed for that. Then in order to transact the content matter in an effective manner, you as a teacher also make use of many teaching learning materials or teaching aids or self-improvised teaching learning materials. Why you do that? You do that so that the learning can be enhanced to the optimum level among the students. Now, if you have used particular teaching learning material or teaching aids, to what extent those teaching learning materials have been proved effective? In order to know, in order to ascertain the effectiveness of that teaching learning material or teaching aids, we have to evaluate our teaching process as well as the students' learning. On the basis of students' learning results, we make a judgment whether that particular material has been successful or has been effective in terms of enhancing the learning among the students or not. So for that, we need evaluation. In other words, we can say that the effectiveness of content matter, the teaching methods and strategies, and the teaching learning materials, in order to ascertain the effectiveness of these 3 M's, we need evaluation. Then evaluation is needed to grade a child and promote him to the next class. That means to grade a child as whether he is falling in A grade, B grade, outstanding, excellent, or the other grades as specified by the different examining bodies or the school authorities, and promoting him to the next class on the basis of those grades, we need evaluation. Another need of evaluation is to make evaluation as assessment of learning and assessment for learning. That means assessment of learning means we, on the basis of evaluation or on the basis of assessment, we try to grade the child and to promote him to the next class. That is assessment of learning. That means we assess or we evaluate the learning among the students so that he or she can be graded and promoted to the next class. Whereas assessment for learning, this means assessment for learning, that means we try to identify the learning difficulties of the students and provide remedial measures so that learning can be enhanced so that achievement can be enhanced among the students. So this is assessment for learning. So evaluation, why we are doing evaluation? We must be as a teacher clear about this, whether the assessment is done for promoting or grading the student, or whether that assessment is being made for improving the learning of the student. If it is for grading of the student, then it will be assessment of learning. And if the assessment or evaluation is done for identifying the learning difficulties and enhancement of learning, then it will be termed as assessment for learning. So, for these all reasons, as you can see on the screen, we need evaluation. That is, to identify the learning difficulties, to provide remedial measures, to ascertain the effectiveness of content matter, methods, and materials, and to grade a particular child and promote him to the next class. So these are the reasons for which the evaluation is needed by us. So learners, today we discussed about the processes of measurement, assessment, about which we have already discussed in the previous lesson also. In this lessons, we deliberated in detail on the meaning and elements of evaluation, that evaluation is having the widest scope, including measurement and assessment processes plus value judgments. Then we discussed about the similarities and the differences between the processes of assessment and evaluation. And in the last, we discussed on the need and importance of evaluation. Why evaluation is needed in the schools? So, why evaluation is needed in the school so that the students can be graded, their learning could be enhanced. I hope you have all understood about the aspects of measurement, assessment, and evaluation, and what are the similarities or the differences between these two terms. But we should remember one thing, that assessment and evaluation, they are interchangeably used, synonymously used, but a difference is there which we should keep in mind. I hope you have understood about all these aspects in a better way. Thank you very much.